For this demo, our input signal is a low-level 5 GHz pulsed sinusoid. A pulsed sinusoid should produce a sink-shaped series of peaks in our measurement spectrum. However, the noise floor is currently masking this weak input signal. We'll turn on trace averaging, which can help identify steady signals in the presence of random noise. With trace averaging turned on, we can confirm the presence of a signal at 5 GHz, but we don't see much detail. We'll save this trace for comparison before improving the measurement sensitivity. Now, we'll turn on trace 2 with averaging. On this trace, we'll improve the sensitivity by reducing the resolution bandwidth. Reducing RBW will not only drop the noise level, but also sharpen the peaks in our spectrum. However, reducing RBW also causes sweep time to increase sharply. For this demo, we will assume that we don't want our sweep time to be much longer than 100 milliseconds. As the resolution bandwidth is dialed down, notice how the displayed average noise level, or DANL, drops. Also note that the sweep time is quickly rising. We'll stop at an 18 Hz resolution bandwidth, which gives us a sweep time of 103 milliseconds. By reducing RBW, we drop the noise floor by over 5 dB and have revealed much more detail in our signal. So far, we've only uncovered the principal lobe of the sync pattern. We can make some more adjustments to view the side lobes as well. On this trace, we'll turn off our input attenuation, which will directly increase our signal-to-noise ratio. Input attenuation helps protect the analyzer's input circuitry. Take care to never exceed the analyzer's maximum input power rating of 30 dBm. To set the attenuator to 0 dB, we must manually punch in the value using the number hard keys. Reducing our input attenuation by 6 dB dropped our noise level by the same amount. The additional sensitivity has revealed the first pair of side lobes in our sync pattern. Finally, we will use the internal preamp to increase the signal-to-noise ratio. By using a preamp, we can drop the noise floor 10 dB or more, depending on the frequency. By reducing RBW, minimizing input attenuation, and using the internal preamp, we were able to drop the noise floor by over 25 dB.